Okay, so this is our Rebound Award. This is actually a very special year this year. I want all of you to know going forth, and I think for the last 19 years, we've just done one award per category, and we decided as a team that there's just so many amazing, amazing stories that we're no longer going to keep it to one.
Absolutely.
And tonight is the first night that we're starting with this new tradition. So going forth, if you've got a really good story from somebody in your downline who's really rebounded back, we want you to submit. Because come next year at our 2017 convention, which there's only 2 hours left to register for, coming next year, there'll be many more here on stage because we're really going to start recognizing as many stories that are presented to us. So I'm going to have Theo right now share with you what the Rebound Award is all about and how it came to be.
Oh, excellent. Thank you.
You're welcome.
Definitely give it up for all the lovely ladies in the audience. You guys look very, very good today.
Enjoys.
Very good, very good. Most of you guys know my story, as an NBA guy that rebounded from some injuries. But it was just some great blessings along the way. I want to give it up for Ted Suriano and all the work that he does. He's diligent. He's always in my corner. He's always doing great things with the Rebound product, and we continue to grow in that product. My story, is always amazing to me to even tell it. To go from a high to a low to a high again. Having an opportunity to get drafted 1995, 18th pick, NBA, lifelong goal, a dream come true. To be playing in the NBA, having success, and then start to have certain injuries. I did everything I could to make sure to kill my body, when staying up late, when drinking no alcohol, was doing any bad devices, but my body was still breaking down. I didn't know what was going on at the time, so I can tell you to play and deal with the knee issues, deal with some of the aches and pains, and got all the way to the point I played 6 years strong. Had a couple knee surgeries, had some ankle injuries, and everything was just wonderful. We had one of the best teams in the league, had the best record in the league in 2001 with the Philadelphia 76ers. And we was on a high. I was an all-star. Allen Iverson was an all-star. We just went into the Hall of Fame. Everything was just on a high. And I just went up for a routine block shot, came down on my wrist, and broke my wrist. And things changed from that point on. Like I said, you start off a high, then you go to a low. I just made the All-Star team. The All-Star game was coming up 2 weeks later. And now I got to get surgery for a broken wrist. So needless to say, I didn't play in that All-Star game, but I did get a chance to participate in all the activities. Lo and behold, you come back and you think, okay, I just got to heal, come back, we make the playoffs, and we can move forward. But what happens, because you've been injured a few times, you had the knee, you've had a few things, the coaches, the team, they lose confidence in you. So you end up getting traded. We went from I had the best record in the league to getting traded to Atlanta, which is a low, which was the worst team in the league. So having the opportunity to go to Atlanta, getting rehab, trying to come back, and going up for a routine jump to get the ball, tore the labrum in my hip. So I'm just going through it and had to have surgery, got recouped from that, but didn't really recoup to the point where I could play at my level. So I overheard Mike Glenn, who just spoke not too long ago, who introduced me to Youngevity, to the mineral products, and actually schooled me on what mineral deficiency was. Exercise without supplementation is... Absolutely, absolutely. And that's what my body was going through. And another high that comes, I said the high, now you went to the low. And now the high that comes again is me being introduced to to the minerals, being introduced to the Youngevity family. And having the opportunity to build my body back to where I would come back, be up for Defensive Player of the Year, lead the league 3 years in a row for block shots, and just go on to have a multi-year contract and play 10 more years. So, you know, this is what this is a board is about. Stories like this, where you have people that come and they have these great stories where they rebound themselves through their career, through financially, just through hardship to come back to life. You know, you can always do it with faith, and I'm a big believer in faith and what God has done for me. So I just thank Dr. Wallach, thank the Youngevity family. I love you guys. You guys are a big family and are a big part of my life, and I thank you.
That's amazing. He's amazing, isn't he? We love Theo, and we're so blessed that he's part of the Youngevity family. So Theo, we have three equally amazing stories to share with you tonight. Yes. And I am going to share, and Steve is going to share, and then I will share again the three stories, and then we will bring the award recipients up, and they will receive the Rebound Awards from Theo. Our first winner this evening, it's weird to call it a winner, and I hope nobody cries when I tell this story, and I hope I don't cry when I tell this story, is Asif Chisti. Am I going to say that right? Asif, are you in here this evening, Asif Chisti? Stand up. Can you stand up? There you go. Everybody, this is Asif. He's someone who has overcome some amazingly difficult obstacles in his life, and yet he's incredibly inspiring and motivational. He was born in a third world country. He was born in Pakistan. He's born to uneducated parents and a mother who was deaf. His mother, having challenges of her own, as you can imagine, left him at home one day in the afternoon, and he was sleeping during his nap. He was 3 years old. He awoke, he couldn't find her, and he decided to go outside and see if she was outside. He was immediately hit by a bus. His little left leg was crushed and left into fragments. From the age of 3 years old until he was eight, he learned to walk on crutches with his left leg dangling and useless. He remembers constantly being in pain and often pulling bone fragments from his leg. It was at the age of eight that leg had become gangrened, and there was no alternative but to amputate it. For the next 10 years, he would undergo painful surgeries, grafting skin on his leg as he continued to grow. They would remove skin from various parts of his body to help graft that leg. And it took a total of 10 years to completely heal. Life in a third world country, as you guys can all imagine, is extremely hard. And the fact that he even survived this accident, let alone the gangrene, the amputation, the countless surgeries, life was so much harder for him as an amputee. He would suffer severe discrimination, especially from his own family. His brothers and his sisters turned against him. They were not only embarrassed by him, but as you see in Asif's culture in Pakistan, they believe that the disabled are meant to be cursed by God, and that you are suffering for the sins of your own parents. And remember, his mother was deaf. He was ridiculed, shunned, beaten, and rejected by both society and his family. And despite his harsh circumstances, he never wavered in his perseverance or his positive spirit. Everyone says they never even hear him complain, even to today, and he is always smiling. His experiences propelled him forward and made him work harder at succeeding. He not only went on to become the first and only person in his family to be educated, but he achieved this amazing feat, and he received a double master's. Wow. He speaks five languages. He has an undergrad degree in computer science, and he has the master's in journalism and political science. Boy, I should have practiced this backstage. And as if these achievements were not enough, he became a bodybuilder and a personal trainer at a local gym, motivating others while doubling the gym's membership and instituting a successful program to get teens off the streets, live a healthy lifestyle by exercising, and stop smoking. While he was pursuing his dream, he became a motivational speaker, and he joined Toastmasters International in Pakistan. He himself would go out to the garbage dumps and hand out bags of cooked food, bottled water, to all the children there in his neighborhood. While in Pakistan, he learned of Youngevity and the 90 for Life message, and he actually started spreading that message in Pakistan. And now, while in the U.S., can you guys imagine how long he's been in the U.S.? Try 9 months. He is once again working as a personal trainer at a gym in Napa, California, where he continues to bodybuild, inspire others, and through his work, continue to spread the 90 for Life message. He's recently ranked up to SEMD and will be attending the convention in Utah for the very first time. Asif shows the true spirit of rebounding from adversity.
Absolutely.
And that he should be considered for the Rebound Award with Youngevity, and Youngevity couldn't agree more. So I hope all of you put your hands together for Asif's story today. Asif, why don't you join us on stage? Come on up. Sorry for crying. Thank you so much. Thank you. here, out of the way.
I want to take this platform and I want to thank you, Dr. Joel Wallach, Steve Wallach and Michelle, and especially my wife, Omnia, for bringing me to Youngevity. If you can raise your hand. That's my wife. So I want to talk about fears. Everybody in this building have fears in their life, and they see fears every day. I have seen a lot of fears in my life every day. And I went through them every day. I just want to say one thing. I'm a little bit emotional. Whenever you see fear knocking at your door, please don't run away. Go ahead, open that door, look the fears into their eyes, and say, get the hell out of my property. When you overcome your fears, you're gonna achieve more. That's my message to Youngevity Nation. Love you all. Love you, Dr. Joel Wallach. Thank you so much.
Thank you so much.
Stay on stage with us right over here. You gonna do the next one? Oh! So I can dry my eyes up. I will turn the next story over to Steve.
Well, after that,
they're all
I don't
equally
have dry
good.
Eyes.
They're all equally good.
They
all
are.
Of these stories are equally amazing.
So our next recipient, our next rebound recipient,
thank you,
is Mayor Brian Baum. Mayor, are you in the audience today? Mayor Baum?
He's here. I know those kids
are
here.
I know he's here somewhere. I see the fingers pointing. Please stand up, Mayor Baum. So some of you have heard Mayor Baum's story in the past, but Mayor Baum was diagnosed several years ago with stage 4 liver cancer, I believe, and renal cancer, excuse me. And he wasn't given high hopes of survival by his doctors. Tom Chenault introduced him to my father, Dr. Wallach, and my father sat and met with Tom and Mayor Baum several years ago. And to hear Mayor Baum tell his story, he said, you know, what your father gave me was hope. He gave me a reason to live. He gave me expectation that I could live and survive from this. And his story is so touching, and I'm gonna let him come up and tell the details of it. But, you know, it's to hear him tell this story and to get to know his family and his children that are here with him as well, and to hear his story of survival, you know, it brings tears to my eyes because he attributes, at least in some part, his survival from this deadly cancer to my father. And so I so appreciate that. Mayor Baum, would you please come up and receive your Rebound Award?
God, I couldn't get through it. I practiced backstage and like, oh, I'm gonna lose it on stage. Amazing story.
Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.
Yep.
Oh boy, you never do that. You never turn a microphone over to a former mayor. So we're going to be here for the next 2 hours. I don't know what you've heard about my story. I was diagnosed with stage 4 renal cell carcinoma. Actually, it was about 6 years ago. It was 6 years ago, 2 days ago, that I had my surgery where they removed a football-sized tumor, my third rib up, and they thought they got it all. And about 2.5 years later, I had 3 lymph nodes that doubled in size. And they grew to be about the size of a softball. And Tom and I had been doing a radio show for a number of years. And he said, and I had been taking 90 for life. And he says, you know what? He says, you're not going anywhere. He says, I want you to sit down with Dr. Wallach and talked with him. And I brought my kids. And he did something so miraculous for me. He did. He gave me hope. And that hope is something that's carried me through my life. And I will tell you right now that they cannot prove whether or not I have it or I don't have it. And I've gone through a lot of changes in my life, but I will tell you one thing. The one thing that has never changed is my kids and the love I have for my family and for my friends and my Youngevity friends, because Youngevity is my family.
All right, congratulations.
And it's your family too. And choose to bring other people into your family, because you will bless them like I've been blessed, like you cannot imagine. The Lord has blessed me to no end. And the biggest blessing was my friendship with Tom and Denise Chenault and the Farduluses. and everybody else.
Love it.
Thank you.
Thank you. Please stay on stage. Okay, so I just cannot cry anymore. I love all of these stories, and I love the final and third gentleman that we're bringing up onto the stage today. And I'm actually gonna give him the microphone because I don't think anyone can tell his story better than him. I will tell you this, it is Jimmy Duran. Jimmy, is he coming? Was in a motorcycle accident 15 months ago. Watch this man take the stage. If he's coming. Otherwise, Lewis is going to tell his story. Ah. All right. It's okay. We'll try to catch him. I'm so sorry he's missed this moment, but Jimmy Duran is just an incredible leader on the Spartan team. He indeed was in a motorcycle accident 15 months ago. His story is unbelievable of his recuperation, the rebounding that he did to come back and be this amazing leader within Youngevity. And Theo, we couldn't be more blessed. He truly is an amazing leader to all of these people out here and an inspiration to everybody that meets him. So I will make sure that you at least get a chance to meet him before you leave today. But I did want to please let him know, and I see all of you guys on your cell phones trying to find him. Please let him know how much we loved him, how much we found his story to be so incredible. And we will make sure he gets his moment with Theo. So thank you, all of you.
Thank you.